Today is Thursday, so it's technically 6 days post-op. Tomorrow, around maybe 11 a.m.-ish, will be a complete week post-op. And so we went down to Macon for my appointment, for my post-op. Me thinking I'm going to get my drains taken out and being put in my faja. But come to find out, one, my doctor doesn't have them in his office. He had to order them, but he didn't tell my aunt that, so that we could have had it ordered so that he could put me in it today. So anyway, so we have to have the faja ordered. And then as he was looking at everything, we had a piece of paper that we had to sign about how much my draining tube was put out. And because it was putting out too much fluid, he was like, no, you have to have your drains in for another week. So unfortunately, I'm still bound and I still have draining tubes on me. Good morning, guys. Today is officially 1 week post-op. As I said yesterday, I still have my drains in. So I have, I'm still with draining tubes. I don't have a faja yet, but because I had a waist trainer, first off, my doctor didn't tell my aunt that we had to order it so that it'll be at yesterday's appointment. So we ordered it at yesterday's appointment. And because I still have my drains in, my next appointment, when he tries to take them out, that's when he'll put me into the actual faja. And he said it'll be easier to help because you're going to need help getting into it. So, we're 7 days out. From being in the car yesterday for so many hours, my body is very, very stiff. So I'm in as much pain as I was, when it comes to walking around, like I was on Monday. I mean, like I was last week at the beginning of the surgery process. What else? I still need to get up and move around. Like I said, like initially yesterday before going to surgery, I could stand up at least, straight like this. I slouch over just a little bit, but I wasn't like completely, just slouched. I could stand straight. Now I walk like this, like my back is over because I can't even try to like lift anything like that. It hurts too bad. Then I took the day he marked up my stomach for the surgery. Then yesterday, my aunt took pictures of my abdomen, and I got those. And you can look at it, and you can visibly tell that it's, like, literally just still swollen from, bruising and surgery and stuff. But it doesn't look, how you can look at fat and be like, yeah, that's just kind of fat. You can look at it and literally see that it's, like, bubbled, it's still swollen and still fluids. It looks good, but I'm a visual person, so I need to see like the full thing to see if I like what I see. So far I like the straightness of it all, but I'm not sure. Again, I don't see the full effect. So that's it for today. If anything else pops up, I will let you guys know. See you next time. So it's later on today, Friday. No, Saturday. Oh, hell. What am I? What is this? I got my days mixed up, y'all. Today is Saturday. Yes, today's Saturday. I was able to get some sleep last night. I woke up twice. And luckily I was able to go back to sleep. The third time Hendrix was whining, I woke him. So he woke me up to get up, use the restroom, and wanted to play for the day. But I had like really sharp pains in my incisions. So I got up, got him situated, and I laid on the couch, again. However, I realized that I can't really lay on the couch because when you lay on your couch, your natural reaction is to lay the way you normally lay. And my body like turned to like, just like sprawled out to sleep, and it hurt so bad. So I got back in my chair and have been sitting and watching movies since then. I needed to run to the leasing office to sign some paperwork for me to say that I'm leaving for the day, leaving for my lease, and I fell outside, stomach first. So I believe that my arms braced me some. It hurt, but luckily I had my binder on, so yeah. But now I'm still in pain, but I'm not, the pain that I feel now is not necessarily like, oh, it's the pain from falling, more so as like the pain from just that I've been feeling this entire time. So yeah, so that's what I'm doing. So I'm laying down, I'm waiting for my food to come. I'm finna sit down. I took some medication and I'm finna watch television, some anime, and Hendrix is still in trouble because this morning I'm trying to get him into a routine where the first thing he does when he wakes up is just, you know, lays around for like a few minutes, and then he goes and uses the restroom, and then after he uses the restroom, he eats. So he, I might have to do it the other way around, but not everybody is hungry when they wake. It's more so likely that you have to use the restroom before you're hungry when you wake up. But he has been using the restroom and then like moments later or a few minutes later using the restroom where he's not supposed to go. So instead of putting his time out, putting him in his crate to time out, that's where he sleeps. So that's where he has now created his comfort, especially because it's like this big comfy like blanket that's in there for him. I mean, it's like really plush, and so I know he loves that. I took the metal part out, the plastic part out, and I just sat it there. So that's his timeout chair, his timeout area. So he's upset that he can't break out of his timeout area. But yeah, he like pooped on my chair, he tore open a bag of my candy, he did all of this stuff while I was out walking. So he's in trouble, but I dropped y'all. But yeah, he's in trouble. So other than that, that's it for today. My swelling is going down some. I can feel it. Like yesterday when I put my waist trainer on, yesterday when I put my waist trainer on, it's a three latch, and I can only get it to the first latch to close it. So today I was able to get it to the second latch, so that was good. I want to put it back on in a little while, just for some more hours. Probably might sleep in it. And that is it for today. That's it. Peace. What's up, guys? Today is October the 10th. Today is Monday, and I'm low. I ain't gonna lie. My depression has, I woke up, you know, and was slapped with depression. And I don't know if it's with the season, because, you know, seasonal depression is coming around. Just being cooped up in the house, being, you know, going stir crazy. My house doesn't look what it usually looks like because of moving. So all my pictures and everything is taken down. Like, my house is just kind of like empty, and so because everything is in one room, so I was just like, I just woke up and I was just not feeling it at all. And so Chloe, my niece, her birthday is on Wednesday, but her party is this weekend. And so if I didn't tell it, my drains are still in because I still have a lot of fluid. So I'm supposed to go back to my doctor on Thursday to see, you know, for, of course, for another checkup, and then also to get my faja, and to see if he's going to remove it. So I just text him, which I really love about him. I love the fact that I have like availability to him as such. But I text him to ask him about clearance, because I don't want to miss my niece's birthday. I already missed my nephew's birthday, and, you know, during that time, of course, my depression, I felt some kind of way. And everybody was like, you know, listen, you know, it's going to be another event. It's going to be, you know, you have your niece's birthday, so, you know, it's okay to miss this one.
And so now it's my niece's birthday and there's something coming up and people are like, you know, there's going to be another. And I'm like, I'm just right now. I don't want to hear. I don't want to continue to keep putting off saying that there's going to be another. There's going to be another. And so yes, I'm worried about my health, but I'm worried about my physical health. I want to make sure that my physical health is okay, but also my mental health, because not going, so it's kind of a catch 22, because if I don't go because of my physical health, it's not going to make my mental health any better, and then your mental health affects your physical health, so it's just like a double-edged sword. But like I said, I texted him, I'm waiting for him to give me a call. I was talking with my babe and he was just like, well, you know, I don't want you to go and you just sit there and, you know, you just have to sit and then you regret that you go. But I was like, yeah, I understand. But like with my nephew, he went to Andretti's for his birthday this year. So in that case, yeah, if my niece was going to like, let's say like Jump Air or something like that, then I'm like, yeah, you know what? Auntie's had surgery. I would just be sitting there. I wouldn't even be able to play. It would make sense. But because her birthday party is at the house, I'm like, I'll just be like every, you know, all the adults, you know, you just sit around and have conversation. And at this point, it's kind of like really what I'm craving. It's just conversation. Granted, you know, my peeps came last night to see me, but you know, they had to leave. So a few days of not being in my house and being able to, you know, communicate. And even if it's hearing my brother yelling at me for traveling after surgery, you know, it is what it is. I just want to see my niece and my nephew. I want to feel Houston again. I really miss Texas. The irony is today is 365 days of being in Atlanta. And so I want to go back. I want to, which is funny because that's what I did last year. I gave her birthday present the night as I was leaving. And I came in, packed, you know, unpacked my house. And that Thursday, that Friday, I flew right back to Houston for her birthday party because she turned 5. And so I want to do that again. So right now, me and Hendrix are outside on the patio. Because I needed fresh air. I was going crazy. I wanted to cry. The fresh air is helping. It's definitely helping right now. I don't know what's going on with Hendrix. I don't know what he's trying to get to, but he's whining. But that's the update for today. That's the update for today. Hopefully I'll be able to make this flight. I gotta get out the house. I gotta get out the house. And I want to see Texas. I want to feel Texas again. I want to see my Texas family, my nieces, my nephew, even see my big-headed brother, my sister-in-law. And so, yeah, I'll follow up with you guys later. It is now 7:00. I made a post, I made a video earlier, or the last clip earlier, about just waking up and not feeling good. And I was outside for a little bit, came in and like, you know, freshened up my womb and my wounds. And I put my binder on, you know, put on some new, you know, just new clothes, washed up and everything. And I was still feeling sad and still just like legit, just like depressed. And fast forward to now, when I came back in, you know, I sat down and did all, like I said, did everything. And I took I took one of my volumes and just kind of scrolled through, continue watching television. And I can say that I genuinely feel better, which is crazy for me because I feel like this is the first time I feel like I've ever noticed that I was in a low state, took the proper medication, and feel like it brought me back to a manageable level. Yeah, so I'm gonna eat and continue watching television and hopefully stay baseline. Peace. I get to see my Cameron and Chloe this weekend.
There's no amount of pain that I can be in. There's nothing that can be said to me. These two little people, they are my people. Like, look at them.
Hey.
Thank you.
Happy
Sad. Happy Sad.
Auntie.
What?
Is he turn around?
Why am I turning around?
It's turn around.
Why?
Good morning. Say happy Saturday.
Happy Saturday.
So today's my birthday.
It did get wet. We
tried
to go. Why are you looking like that?
Okay. Okay.
Put your hand on your hip. Say cheese. You gotta throw your hip out like this today.
Hey, girl.
In the whole wide world, like the peace that I have found, and the little things and the joy they bring.
Okay, look, guys, today is October the 12th. Today is Wednesday. Shout out to Auntie's favorite princess. Today is her 6th birthday, and as I said the other day, I did get to go down to Texas on Friday, so I'm absolutely excited about that. Recovery, I feel good. I still feel bloated like a balloon. My skin is still sensitive to touch. It's a weird feeling. Like, it feels like I was blown up with like numbing air. So like when I touch my stomach, it feels, you know how you get your dental work done and you like touch your mouth and you have that, like, you touch it but it has that, like, that numbing feeling, like you feel your skin but the pain sensors, or the just the sensors in general on the other end, it kind of has this like numbing kind of feeling. That's how my abdomen feels. The upper half is not as sore, but the lower half is still, that's what's tender to touch. But anyway, so yeah, so that's it. That's all I have for today. Okay, y'all, so today is October 13th. Today makes post-op visit 2. So I got one of my dresses.
Yeah, I think just gonna be even be burning gas. Hey, yo, you know, I never thought I'd see the day where I, if any of those of you who watch Everybody Hates Chris, his dad, I never thought I'd see the day where I would turn on him and mean it.
And mean it.
And mean it 100%. Nope.
I mean, just full on mean it. Listen,
Hendrix, you will allow, fam. That costs money. I'm gonna need you to come.
Bro, like,
barking costs 10 cents a bark.
I need you to understand, you are a bougie dog. You know, you eat refrigerated food. I spent $20.
Show the look. Hey,
because your food gotta go in the refrigerator. I'm gonna need you to hush.
Like, you a little too loud for somebody that don't pay not one bill.
at all. I mean, and it's the most expensive of them, man, all.
Jesus.
Listen, me and Chris are struggling, okay? Because adulthood slapped the entire hell out of us.
Man, look.
You ever laugh so you don't cry?
Look,
that's where we at.
Hey, she depressed. I'm depressed. Our bank accounts are depressed. Hendrix is depressed. And he's supposed to be making us feel better. He's sad, too. I know y'all hear him crying. Jesus. This is ridiculous at this point.
It's so bad. You know, when, you know, you adult yourself when you say, what am I going to eat? And you say you got food in the house.
No.
The household has to say, no, fam.
No, you don't.
You on your own.
So don't even come up here with that. Don't come in here with that beer. Don't you come in here thinking I got anything for you.
Y'all, I'm like, we sitting here tallying up our change. Please pick the shallot. We are sitting here, like, counting our coins, trying to figure out what do we have as a team.
How you
hold on. My dad calling. Everybody's calling. Everybody won't let. First off, I just wanted the salad.
That's it.
We wanted the salad. She calling back. We ain't got that salad. The salad like
$50. The salad costs too much for y'all to not have it. It should be in stock. Every time I ask for it.
Why is lettuce so expensive?
Hey, I ain't gonna lie to you. If I call a restaurant where the price is a little bit up there, every time, it don't matter what I ask for. If I ask for it, it better be there. That's what the simplest thing on the menu.
It ain't salad,
and you running down near $35-$40. You better give me shit.
Man, listen, y'all.
They gonna call back. Hey, we don't have this. Yes, you do. Make it.
Figure it out. Man, listen. I'm sitting here. We trying to pinch pennies. Man, I'm independent. I got you, babe. Baby, I got you. My pocket said, babe, who? Humble yourself. You don't have to be independent all your life.
I got this. Look, I knew to shut up because I ain't got it either. Nah.
It was bad.
You know, how would you guys like to pay? Cash or credit? Jesus paid it off.
Look, y'all got some dishes.
Fam, hey, look. I like to clean.
What about a clean IOU?
You know what I'm saying? Fam, look.
Okay. What about just a good old IOU? Listen, y'all. Today has been.
Look, I got this nice little wristband for you.
I got an Apple Watch.
Hey,
I got a service animal. Listen, you might give him back, but you know he.
I'll come see him on weekends. You know, he'll be fine.
He could be the service animal for the restaurant. He could. I feel like he's cute enough to pay. You know, put him a little tip jar. Money'll be made.
He a mascot.
Discombobulated. Yeah. I have on this fa ha 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 ha. I can't breathe.
Y'all, the fa la la la. Fa la la la.
Y'all, this garment is a compression garment. It's like two sizes too small. It's I can't sweat. It is hot.
Oh no! Look.
Not the windows.
Hey, the windows.
Luckily,
it's about to be winter time.
Luckily, the fall, cool air.
Man. But now, look, we in there, we trying stuff on. I was like, usually I wear about a 36. Now, I'm a slim guy, roughly. I ain't never been a big dude. But 36 is usually about the biggest I've ever been. I said, you know, I'm trying to find something, a nice little slim fit or whatever, so that way I can, you know, have a sleek look for, you know, for my legs. Somebody brought me a 31, fellas. I know as soon as I said 31, y'all felt
visual.
My pain.
I needed it for visual.
So, this is a 31 in dress pants. I'm going to let y'all sit on that. 31 in dress pants. My McNuggets couldn't breathe, couldn't move. I couldn't turn. She think this this fajita thing she wearing is something. Not. Can I tell you it's 26? A goddamn breath. You breathing on my arm and her neck a little too hard.
I feel like you was earning a little bit too much energy, you know, which means you're going to eat a little bit more than what you normally eat. And we calculating down to the
same. Well, you better eat everything we set in front of you. If I set the remote, you better eat it. Sick of this. But y'all, she brought me a 31 and go, these fit.
No, the 36 was too big.
They made it to my knees. My knees. I finally pulled them pants up high. Y'all remember?
Y'all city boy.
Man, no, I wasn't no city boy. No. Y'all remember that scene in White Chicks when what's his name tried to put them girl pants on?
That was me and my doctor today trying to put this fahaha on.
No, that was literally just me a few minutes ago trying to fit them 31s on.
No, that was go home. And Dr. Brown, okay, trying to put this thing on. Can you see it?
I couldn't even do that in them 31. I couldn't get a finger down between my...
Nah, I feel you on that one because I can't. Y'all, let me tell you, this dress, ladies, I put on this dress because the way it's got straps and it was hot and I'm not supposed to sweat. So I put on this dress and I didn't realize, you guys, stripes, circles, and patterns make a difference. So we're walking through the mall and I'm like, Chris, I look like a pop can of Pillsbury. Slut rolls.
He's like, the Mrs. Butterworth.
He's like, no, you don't. Me, just the fuck I do.
Wait. Yo. Yeah. I'm just saying. Yo, man. It's 30 cents per wine. It's 10 cents per breath. You owe me 40 cents. For every sound that come out your mouth. At this point, man, I'm going to just have to open up a tab.
And the bad thing is, he won't let us pick him up.
Nope. He just want to cry. Y'all, is he one of them kids? Sit there and throw a tantrum. Until all, you know what? Say something else.
Chris said, say something else. He said,
uh-huh. All right, I'll give you a discount on that one. It's 20 cents instead of 40.
Man, listen.
Close your eyes. Go ahead. Open them.
Just gave me the biggest hug. Worth it. Absolutely worth it. Just absolutely worth it. Excuse me, ladies. Oh, she's going to love this. Oh, thank you.